Hi, I'm Taylor Rhodes. I'm the CEO of SMS Assist. We provide property management as a service. Our customers have thousands of physical locations. Those might be retail stores or restaurants or bank branches. And each one of those physical locations requires electricians and plumbers and roofers and snow removal, all of the things that go into the category of property management. What we do is we build a technology platform that seamlessly connects the suppliers of those services with our customers, and we ensure that the work gets done in a higher quality, lower cost way. You know, I always tell people that growth is a good problem to have, but it's still a problem. And when you're going through hyper growth as a company, it pressurizes every part of your system. That can be your hiring and keeping up with your hiring demands. And once you've solved your hiring demands, then you have training problems to solve. How do we train all those people well? And all of that sort of rolls up into cultural pressure. Companies that are cool, inspiring places to work when you're small, all of a sudden wake up and there's hundreds more people running around. And we haven't kept up with the systems and the tools and the training, and it's harder to get things done. So one of the greatest challenges companies have is enduring and figuring out how to scale through that hyper-growth-induced cultural pressure. And that is something that, you know, any company that's going through those barriers of going from 50 people to 500 people faces. I think you have to look at your business as an entire system. And so truly from end to end, you have to understand, well, not only how are we going to hire well, but ultimately, how does our product roadmap need to change as we bring more customers on and everything in between? So for me, as a CEO helping a company scale through hypergrowth, you have to keep widening out your aperture and looking at the entire system, bringing in leaders to complement your current workforce who have been through those things before and can run and manage a certain part of your system up through those scaling barriers. You know, I think technology is changing business models every single day, and business models are made up of people. So really what technology is doing is it's changing the way people work. And so one of the challenges we all have in business is, how do you use technology to do more of the task level work so that your human employees can actually work on higher level, more insightful things? And if you're not really careful to pay attention to that, you fall behind. So as you think about technology revolutionizing business models hand in hand, how are the roles in our company and how are people work changing, and how do you constantly retrain people and move them up in the value stack as technology takes more and more of the lower value task work out? And that's a challenge that all CEOs should be facing, because technology has the potential to create power in every business out there. Yeah, I think that a lot of companies focus on how am I going to do recruiting, or what some companies call talent acquisition. And what we found is that not only is it acquiring the right type, it's actually developing them. And development of people is correlated to one of the greatest reasons people will stay for a long time at a company. Do I feel like I have the opportunity to progress here, to learn, to become more valuable? And I think a lot of companies focus on hiring right, but not as many really focus on developing right. And what we found is the more we invest in developing our people, then the more engaged they'll be, the more they will believe that they have a great career path with us, they'll stay longer. And as they stay longer, we accumulate the benefit of all of that wisdom staying within the company. So I think it's focusing on not only acquiring right, but really being intentional about developing your talent along the way.